This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and our podcast today focuses on witchcraft in New England. In the 17th century, there was a widespread belief in the supernatural, and it was generally found in Europe and in America. Among Puritans, the people believed in magic, astrology, and witchcraft. They believed that the supernatural had an impact on the physical world, and they also believed in their Christian religion. Now, there were some common ideas at the time about how to address the issue of witches. People could be put to death for being convicted of witchery. Direct evidence was hard to come by, but most witches were identified as older women. Part of the issue here is that older women were more assertive, they were economically independent, they did not have husbands necessarily, and they tended to violate gender norms. They challenged the idea of God and men as the heads of families. Now, in Salem, the witch trials were the result of a mounting hysteria within the community. In 1691, young girls were attempting to practice divination. They went on to have fits and nightmares, and the elders called this witchcraft. Three women were named as witches, including an enslaved African woman by the name of Tituba. Some scholars believe that she may have been Native American as well. Now, the result was accusations, a series of trials, and of course punishment. You could only avoid punishment in a witch trial by naming other people as witches. And this practice soon became out of control. Hundreds of people accused their neighbors of being witches, and people used witchcraft or the charges of witchcraft against their enemies. 150 people were found involved in witchcraft, and most of them were women. Some of the people confessed. 14 women and 5 men were hanged. Now, the hysteria over witchcraft included women, but men were also a part of this. Any age, including a 4-year-old, could be suspected of being a witch. The leaders began to look at the system of justice finally. The governor of Massachusetts eliminated the Salem court and released the prisoners. They began questioning the testimonies and the confessions. And finally, they discredited the practice of witch hunting. And there became a growing commitment to scientific explanations for those things unseen and those things that could not be accounted for.